In the first step, partnerships are formed between the Whitebait Connection Coordinator, schools and other organisations such as the Department of Conservation. Teachers then begin the inquiry process by asking their class what they already know about freshwater environments and what they might like to know about this topic. This information is then communicated to the Whitebait Connection Coordinator, who uses it to shape their first classroom session.
The Whitebait Connection classroom presentation is collated and delivered by the Whitebait Connection Coordinator. It aims to cover the big picture and introduce key concepts from which to learn more. The Whitebait Connection key concepts always remain the same. They are the values of freshwater, interdependence, connections and cycles from the mountains to the sea, ecology and biodiversity, threats to freshwater environments, and introducing personal and social responsibility, kaitiakitanga. During stage two, coordinators and teachers can begin to link these key concepts with the local context and the early wonderings.
Following stage two, students are inspired to inquire further and big questions can be formed based on a wide foundation of knowledge.
All I knew was that all the streams that like flow around here connected to the sea, but I didn't know like how like there was a connection going all the way up top of the tall mountain and coming all the way back down.
I thought there was only one bit of white bait, like one type, but there's like lots more.
What I didn't know about was the big world, how much percentage of water was in the world, and how much liquid there was, and how much of it we could drink. That was real cool.
Oh, I don't really know about the brackish water, how the fresh water and the salt water meets.
I'd love to see if there's white bait in our own catchment.
Once these questions are formed, the coordinator is informed and the inquiry methods needed to answer these big questions can be researched and planned. Methods may take the form of field trips with water quality testing, community surveys, interviews and much more. The way these traps work is by catching whatever's feeding on the surface of the water. So whatever's, when we set the trap, we aim for having the water level just above this hole that you can see in there. Yep. And then whatever's feeding on the surface in the night, they go in that hole and they can't get back out again. Yeah. Or a few might be able to, but the majority will stay in there.